हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू वन मोर वीडियो स्पेशल बायोटॉनिक, अ चैनल टू मेक बायोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट इजी। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस सेशन वी विल टॉक अबाउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन। स्टूडेंट्स, वी कैन डिफाइन फर्टिलाइजेशन एज द फ्यूजन ऑफ मेल गैमेट विद द फीमेल गैमेट टू फॉर्म डिप्लॉयड जायगोट। Students, this is a common definition which can be asked even for fertilization in plants, and the definition is same. Now, this diagram is of female reproductive system. In human beings, the process of fertilization is internal and it takes place in the ampulla of fallopian tube. Human beings are viviparous. It means we give birth to young ones. In animals such as fishes, amphibians, reptiles and birds, they lay the eggs. They are called as oviparous animals. Please make a note of this. Students, if you're finding this video interesting, then please do like this video and hit the subscribe button to get notification of all my new videos. All right. Students, there are various steps involved in process of fertilization. The first step is the movement of sperm towards the ovum. Students, at the end of sexual intercourse or copulation, male ejaculates semen into the vagina. This semen contains 200 to 400 million sperms. This insertion of sperms into the female tract is called insemination. Most of the sperms die due to acidic environment and phagocytic activity of the uterus. The remaining sperm undergo capacitation. This process requires 5 to 7 hours. Due to capacitation, the acrosome membrane becomes thin and permeable to calcium. The sperm moves at the rate of 1.5 to 3 mm per minute towards the fallopian tube. Sperms are able to reach the fallopian tube partly by their own swimming and partly by the contraction of uterus. The energy for sperm movement comes from fructose, which is present in the semen. The sperms are less active in vagina due to acidic nature created by lactobacilli bacteria, but they are happier in uterus due to its alkaline nature. After capacitation, sperms reach the fallopian tube in just 5 minutes. Students, we can see the sperm movement with the help of this animation. In human females, one ovum is produced during monthly cycle, alternatively from each ovary. This ovum is released in the middle of monthly cycle. It passes into fallopian tube and rests inside the ampulla for some time. The lifespan of ovum is just 1 day, so it is said that the chance of fertilization is maximum if there's a copulation in the middle of monthly cycle. The second step is the entry of sperm into the ovum. Once the sperm comes in close contact with ovum, sperm produces a chemical by the name antifertilizin, which combines with fertilizin of the ovum. This reaction is species specific and it prevents cross fertilization. When the sperm comes in contact with corona radiata, the acrosome covering breaks to release the acrosomal enzymes. These enzymes are acrosine, zonalysine, and hyaluronidase. These enzymes dissolves the corona radiata and zona pellucida in front of it. A small fertilization cone develops from the surface of ovum in the region of animal pole. the sperm head comes in contact with the fertilization cone. Head and part of the neck goes into the ovum, thereby releasing nucleus and centrioles into the cytoplasm. The tail remains outside. Entry of sperm initiates several cortical granule reactions, which converts plasma membrane into fertilization membrane. This step is very important because it prevents subsequent entry of sperm into an ovum, that is polyspermy. The third step is activation of ovum. Students, we know that the female gamete that is released during the ovulation is secondary oocyte. It has just completed metaphase 1 of meiosis 1. Entry of sperm into ovum stimulates secondary oocyte to quickly complete its second meiosis. It forms a mature ovum or definitive ovum. The nucleus is now called female pronucleus. The next step is fusion of nuclei of sperm and egg. Now, the nuclear membrane of both nuclei dissolves and there's a mixing of chromosomal material to form syncaryon. This act is called syngamy or karyogamy. Fertilized egg is now called zygote. Students, there are many advantages of fertilization. The first advantage is, due to entry of sperm into female gamete, it completes its second meiotic division to form ovum. Second advantage is, it converts haploid ovum into diploid zygote. So, it maintains diploid state of an organism, that is 46 chromosomes for human beings. White line membrane is converted to fertilization membrane, which prevents the subsequent entry of sperm into an ovum. The product of fertilization is zygote, so fertilization stimulates embryogenesis, that is the further development of zygote to form embryo and individual. Depending on the type of sperm fusing with an ovum, sex of an individual is determined. So fertilization determines the sex of the baby. Students, I have made a complete video on sex determination. Please watch it. As fertilization is intermixing of chromosome, it creates variation and ultimately it helps in evolution. Students, I hope you have followed all steps in fertilization. I request you all to please like and share this video and subscribe my channel to get notification of all my new videos. Thank you for watching this video. Stay home, stay safe. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.